So today we're going to be doing, we have not one, no, and not two, but three BoxyCharm try-ons from the past 3 months. I have been out of the country, out of the state, traveling. So my BoxyCharm's kind of piled up on me while I've been gone. So we have April, May, and June BoxyCharms to do a little demo, a try-on, and a review. So I've been using all of these products since I've been back in California, which has been about 3.5 weeks, which I know is not a lot, but like, trust me when I tell you, I've been using these products every single day since I got back. So I feel like I can do like a pretty good, and actually some of these things I took with me on vacation. Things from the April box I actually took with me, and they became like part of my like holy grail kit. If you haven't seen the video already, it might, I don't know when it will be. If it's already been posted, I will link it up below, up above, or down below in the description box. But my holy grail vacation makeup, the stuff that really works, that you know, made it all the way through Europe for almost a month when I was traveling around. So some of this stuff actually made it into my holy grail's travel kit. But if you want to see that, so we have 3 months worth of try-ons, and then also we got my July box, which has yet to be opened, so we will also do a little unboxing of that, since there is so much stuff that I have like in front of me from these 3 months. I thought it'd be probably the easiest to follow if I broke it down, and not necessarily by each month, like what came in the April box and what came in the May and what came in June, but kind of how I did my makeup, because you can almost do an entire face worth of makeup using the stuff from this box. So if that sounds interesting, if you want to see how I got this look, if you want to hear my thoughts about some of these products, if you want to see the unboxing for July, then keep on watching. Lot to get through. I'm gonna kind of keep it going as fast as I can, just to make sure that this video is not super duper long. I wrote out all of my notes from all of the different products, because trust me, there are so many. Let's see, I numbered them. There are 17 products that I have from the April, May, and June boxes combined. So we have 17 things to talk about. So I wrote all my notes. So we're gonna kind of keep it going, keep it moving, but hopefully be kind of informative. So the first thing that we have here is the Dr. Brandt Pores No More Vacuum Cleaner Pore Refining Mask. So this came in the April box, and it retails for $47. Yeah. This is an expensive product, $47. It goes on, it's a white mask, it goes on white, you're supposed to let it sit on your face for 5 to 10 minutes until it dries. Once it dries, it changes to like a purple kind of color, and then you wash it off. And I've used this, so this came in the April box, I've used this since April. I'm actually almost done with, I've used this a number of times, and I really quite enjoy this. I think it works pretty well. When I don't notice like a very visible difference when I use it, but I do notice that my skin feels really nice when I wash it off after I've used that. So that's really good. The only downside to this product, it stinks. Yeah, it smells. I don't know if you guys have ever, if you've ever had a perm or like had someone, who, you know, someone who gets perms or just like been in a beauty shop, it smells like ammonium that's in like the perm. Yeah, so it's not great. And like, I've been around perms. My hair's naturally curly. My mother does not have naturally curly hair, but she gets perms, so people think I got my curly hair from her. Thanks, mommy, though. I still love my hair. I got good genes. But it's, yeah, it stinks. It smells like a perm. So that's kind of the only downside, but you only keep it on your face for like 5 to 10 minutes. And once it dries, you don't smell it. I don't really notice the smell when you wash it off. It's just when you're putting it on, it's pretty strong. So if you're sensitive to smells, maybe it's not going to be the best option for you. If you don't really care and you want something that really works pretty well, then I think this is it's a really nice mask. It's expensive, so, you know, kind of weigh the pros and cons. I've enjoyed it, and I've really liked using it, and I will continue to use it until it's gone. So, all right, now moving on along, the next thing that I would use in my makeup routine is a primer. So in the May box, we got this little guy. So this is the Cover Effects Blurring Primer. This, I guess it came in the May box, and it retails for $38. So again, this is another pretty high price tag item. I have quite enjoyed using this product as well. So I've been using this pretty much for like 3 weeks straight, ever since I got back to California and like unpacked my box. Yeah, I've started using it. I really like it. They say it's a blurring primer that instantly minimizes the appearance of pores and fine lines to create a super smooth, flawless, airbrushed look. So this really reminds me of some of the other blurring, pore-filling primers. It has kind of that whipped texture that you will find in like a Benefit Professional or like a Dr. Brandt Pores No More primer. Yeah, and it works kind of the same way. I feel like it is pretty smoothing. When I put it on, I've used it both ways. I've used it in conjunction with some of my other primers that I use on a daily basis. Like over here, I've got, this is my Hourglass Mineral Veil. So I've used it in conjunction with some other primers that I'll put all over my face and then kind of focus this just on my T-zone, nose, and then I really like work some into my smile lines, patting it in. Or sometimes I will also use it just on its own. And I feel like in general, this primer, it works well. It's not quite as pore filling as maybe the Touch and Soul No Pore Blend Primer or my Tarte Clean Slate Primer. Those are super pore filling, but it does like a nice job, and I think it creates kind of a nice base for your makeup. As far as like extending the wear time of your makeup, I think it keeps the makeup on pretty well. It's not going to really cut down so much in oils like I have on my, you know, my nose or my T-zone. I don't notice it doing that, but I do notice it kind of, you know, smoothing and creating a nice base. So I think as in terms of if those are what the things you're looking for in a primer, this gets the job done, and I really like it. And it doesn't have any smell at all, because like sometimes the Dr. Brandt has a very strong, I think it's tea tree oil kind of scent, and this doesn't have that. So it could be like a close facsimile. And I think you actually get more of this for less than Dr. Brandt, so could be a good dupe. All right, now we're moving on along to the product that, you know, if you watched my last video, which I literally just posted, even though I was gone for so long, I did not want this product. I adamantly did not want this product. So this is the Tarte Tartist Pro Glow Illuminator. It's a liquid highlighter, and I got the color Sparkler. Let's take this guy out of the box. Here's the guy. You get like a little tube. This came in the April box, and it retails for $29. So if you saw that video, you know I did not want this at all. I really wanted like the MAC lipstick instead. I had a little mini little sample of it like quite a few months ago, maybe almost a year ago, and I tried it with my foundations, and I felt like it just took my foundation off when I tried to put it on. So I was not a fan of the formula or the product. But I was like, okay, I'm gonna give it a fair shot and I'm gonna retry it. And so I've actually been using it, and I don't hate it like I thought I did. I honestly really don't hate this. So I have it on today in conjunction with some other highlighters, but I put it on first before I put my powder on. So I did my foundation, concealer, and then I tapped this on. Kind of the high points, kind of did like, you know, the little C, high points of my cheek up onto my temple, and then blended it out with my beauty blender. And I think it actually worked really well. It hasn't pulled up any of the foundation that I put on underneath, which is good. And it actually lasts really well. I feel like it really amps up any of the highlighters that you put on top of it, so that's a benefit. Yeah, and it makes your highlighter last all day, because sometimes with certain highlighters, they'll kind of fade. I like to go on with a cream highlighter, so I really like my Kylie Wet Set. I really like some Colourpop Super Shock highlighters, and then put a powder highlight on top of it. So this kind of does a similar thing to those. This one, I just feel like it's a little extra step, because you have to put it on. Remember to put it on before you powder. I also did try the trick where you put this all over your face and then put foundation on top of it. I honestly didn't see that it did anything. It didn't make me look more like glowy or illuminating. If illuminating is a word. But there were certain parts I was wearing like a lighter coverage foundation. There are certain parts because this kind of does, it looks very metallic when you put it on, but there also are some like big chunks of glitter. Like, I don't know. And I just felt like I saw those like peeking through the foundation. And I didn't really say it did anything. I don't think it's quite enough coverage to put under your foundation if something you're looking for that. But I actually did not hate this. Now, the downside is it's $29 and you don't really get very much. I guess you don't need very much. But I feel like this is a little bit of a superfluous product. You know, like you have other highlighters that you use. This just adds another step to your routine. So I had it. I tried it. I didn't hate it. I'm not going to buy it again, especially not for $29. So that's how I feel about this guy. After we put on the highlighter, we're going to powder the face. So next I would go in. This was from the May box. This is the Aesthetica Face Brush. So it's this guy. It's a synthetic domed powder brush. It's very soft. It's slightly tapered at the top. This is great for putting on powder all over your face and like setting your face with powder. So I still like to set my under eyes, my nose, and my smile lines with powder on like a beauty blender. But then I'll go in with this afterwards and kind of powder the whole face. And I do really like it. It's not super densely packed, which I think for powdering the whole face, I like. I don't really like a super dense powder brush for that. Yeah, and I think it actually does a really nice job of distributing the product. And yeah, there's not really much to say. It's just a face brush. $27, though, seems a little high for like a synthetic brush that it is. Would I pay $27 for this guy? No. No, I have like another IT Cosmetics brush that I love, and I'm pretty sure I did not pay $27. I mean, maybe it was in like the $20 range. But it's very soft. I do like it. I'm glad I got it in the box because I have another like powder brush, but $27 is a little steep. Well, let's be real. All right, so moving on along to my favorite. Oh my gosh, my two favorite products that I got in these boxes. So the next thing that I used in when I was creating this look, this is the Alamar Reina de Caribe palette. So this guy, oh my goodness, is gorgeous. Like, look at these colors. It is beautiful. This is probably hands down the best product in these 3 months. Like, just no, straight up, this is the best product that I got in these 3 months. I love it. So this came in June. This was part of the June box, and it is $28, which is like honestly pretty inexpensive for this guy. I love it. The mattes blend literally like a dream. Like, they are so creamy and they're so pigmented. They're gorgeous. And these shimmers are drop dead. Like, they are so beautiful. They are so pigmented, so creamy. They blend so well. I cannot say enough great things about this palette, about all of the colors. The next palette, and this is one that I actually took with me on vacation. So this came in the April box. So this is the ColourPop Golden State of Mind palette. It is an all shimmer shades palette, which when I got it, I was like, I don't know how I feel about that. Will I really use an all shimmer palette? I didn't think so, but I decided to take this with me on the trip, and I am so glad that I had it. This, like I said, April box, oh, $26. That's what I was forgetting. This one is $26, and you get 15 shimmers. So this one, I was very, very happy I had it. The shimmers are a much drier formula in this guy than you see in the Alamar palette. The Alamar palette, so creamy. These guys are quite dry and a little bit flaky. You want to use a glitter glue, and with all of them, they work much, much better with your fingers than they do with a brush. But I am so glad there's really unique colors. Like, this one looks like a white, but when you actually swatch it, It's like a duochrome-y purple. This one is like a gorgeous bronze. This one's a really nice red. Like, there's just, they're all such, it's kind of like a taupey brown. It's just, oh my gosh. These are really, really, really pretty colors. Look at those. So I'm really glad that I had this and I took it on the trip with me. So let me just talk you through kind of how I did this eye look that I have today. So this is kind of a warm, brown, smoky eye look. So I started with the Alamar palette. I went in with Coco Taxi. And Coco Taxi, I just like got a large fluffy brush and I just fluffed that all over my crease, taking it up above the brow bone slightly in order to make sure that some of that warmth and that color really was visible above my crease because I do have slightly hooded eyes. So after I got Coco Taxi, I then went in with a Morphe M433, one of my favorite blending brushes, and then I went on the next, this kind of orangey shade called Tropico. And I kind of did the same thing, worked it into the crease, but keeping it just a little bit lower than where I had Coco Taxi, and really just worked that into the crease to build up a lot of that warmth and the color and like the sultry, you know, Havana vibes. Beautiful. So then after those two, I took a more pointed pencil brush and went into this kind of like dark red, kind of a burgundy-ish shade called Guantanamera. And really focused that on the outer V and worked it slightly into the crease, but again, not quite as far as I went with Tropico. So everything was about building the color up, but every color I kind of kept it smaller and more concentrated towards the outer edge. So then after I built up a really nice kind of red base with Guantanamera, I went on with the Cafecito. Aww, I love like little coffees. Do you remember in was that Courtney and Kim Take Miami when Chloe got addicted to like the Cuban coffees?
Cortadito. I need a cortadito.
With her little cortadito, and she was like lost and like the keys and she couldn't get home. Oh my gosh. One of my favorite episodes. Sorry. Kardashian side note. So I went on this like little cafecito, the brown shade, and really kept that just right in the outer corner, really smoking and darkening up the outer V. And then, you know, kind of just kept building colors and layering them. I would mix the cafecito with Guantanamera. I'd mix Guantanamera with Tropico, kind of just keeping all of the colors, you know, in the outer V, but warming up the crease. So, like I said, I love the shimmer shades in this palette. They are really gorgeous. But for this look, I kind of wanted to also feature the Golden State of Mind palette. So for that guy, I actually went in to one of my favorite shades and one of the ones I got the most use of on my trip. And so I went into Uptight, which is this really gorgeous, like, bronzy color. So I took this color after applying some glitter glue, because again, you want to use a glitter glue with the colors in this palette. So I went with a finger and just patted this all on the lid from the inner corner to about the midway point of my eye. So then after that, I went back in, of course, with some of like Coco Taxi. I went in with Guantanamera and just blended out the edges to make sure that everything was pretty seamless in the transition. So then I finally went in again with the Alamar palette and I used this first kind of light shade called La Costa and took that with like a very, very small little detail brush and put that in my inner corner and kind of blended it on the lid, and then also took that as my brow bone highlight because it's super poppin'. It's awesome. So I love these other colors, all the blues, and the Celia is kind of like a bluey green, which is gorgeous. Like, these are all really, really nice, but like I said, I wanted to kind of try to use a little something else from the Golden State of Mind palette. So overall, these two palettes are a great, great value. Get the Alamar palette if you haven't already, because it is well worth it. And I was very pleased with this little ColourPop guy, so that was a good deal. All right, the next thing was the Jonteblu waterproof eyeliner pencil. We got this guy here. I got the color charcoal. Why can't I speak? So this is just a little eye pencil. It's not super black because it is kind of charcoal, so it's more of a blacky gray. I just put this right in my inner waterline, which it's disappeared. So this is not great for being in your waterline. I put it in my waterline. It looked good when I first did it, but it's been a while since I've actually put this makeup on, and it's sort of gone now. Yeah, so it's not great for that. It works pretty well just as an eyeliner. I didn't use it as an eyeliner today, but it works fine. It's pretty, it kind of tugs on your eye a little bit. It's a little bit dry, I would say, but it only retails for $5. So for a $5 eyeliner, it's not so bad. It's not the most creamy of eyeliners I've ever tried. There's a lot of really great ones at the drugstore that I think could really be good options, but for $5 in the box, I was totally happy with it. And that, again, that came in the June box. Next, we have the Aesthetica 3-Piece Eye Brush Trio. So this came in the May box, and it retails for $45 for these three brushes. So you have a eyebrow spoolie, you have an angled eyeliner brush, and then a pointed eyeliner brush. So I have tried using, I've used all three. They're good. They're fine. I tried both of these out. I really like the pointed eyeshadow eyeliner brush a lot better than I like the angled eyeliner brush. But that's, again, just preference. I mean, it was nice that they included brushes for the eyeliner, considering also in the May box, they included a gel eyeliner. So it was nice that they gave you brushes in case you didn't have them. $45 for this set of three is ridiculous. Like, I'm gonna say it like it is. It's ridiculous. Like, this set of three is not $45, because that means that each one of these brushes is $15. And who in their right mind would pay $15 for one of these brushes? This spoolie is nice, but it doesn't feel super high quality. These feel just like plasticky. Everything's tight with the ferrules. Nothing's broken, but they don't feel like $15 each brushes, and for $45 for these three, just so not worth it. Like, so not worth it. If you want to pay a higher value for brushes, definitely go ahead, but I would expect more for the brushes to feel a little more high quality. If you have your eyeliner brushes, use those already. If you're looking for some to invest in, I would probably go with some less expensive options than these, because $45 for these three brushes is ridiculous. But again, nice that they included them, because also in the May box, we got the Pretty Vulgar, the ink gel eyeliner. So this is $24. It's an ink gel eyeliner. It is the most adorable packaging. I love how it looks like a little inkwell. Oh my gosh, it's really cute. So it unscrews, and then you definitely can't see that, but it has gel eyeliner in there. This is just cute. And full disclaimer, I am terrible at winged eyeliner. Like, I'm just hands down terrible. It is something that I've been working at for a very long time. Since I've gotten this, I have been working on it even more. What I do is, when I'm about ready to go to bed or take my makeup off, I will practice doing winged eyeliner so that if I mess up, I can just take my makeup off and no one will see. I really struggled today's. You can see I did wings with this look. I wish that I hadn't. I wish that I had just done a regular eyeliner on the top and not attempted the wings, because these were like disasters. Took me so long for not a very good result. But I do really like this, and I actually think I kind of like a gel eyeliner better than like a liquid eyeliner for doing wings. I enjoy this formula. I think it glides on really smoothly. Ignoring my terrible wings, the actual eyeliner part on the top of my eyes went on really nicely. It was, like I said, very, very smooth, very, very dark. Lasting power, that I can't really say, because like I said, I put this on at night so that when I mess up, it doesn't matter. So the longest I've probably had this on is maybe 3 hours. I think I am going to be brave and I'm going to try this, just not with the wing. I am not there yet. But just putting on as eyeliner and wearing it throughout the day and kind of giving it a go. If I do that before I post this, I'll put that information in the description box. So, the next thing, because we're still on eyes, we had a lot of eye products in these boxes. This was a different one. I don't know. Tell me, I've been getting BoxyCharm from maybe maybe about 7 months or so, eight months. I don't really remember when my first box was. That's really bad that I don't remember. I've never seen eyelashes before, but I thought this was a really cool idea because, you know, it's kind of like something that it's not going to be different colors for different people. Like, everyone can love it. So these are the Battington Monroe Silk Lashes. These came in the June box and they retail for $28. I think these are beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful lashes. So these are silk lashes. I've actually never had silk lashes before, and I think they're gorgeous. They're very full and they're very, very wispy, which is just my style. So I could not be happier with these lashes. And I think for $28, this is a really good value. And with silk lashes, if you take care of them, they will last for a really long time. Even with some of my like cheap eyelashes from the drugstore, or you get like tons of uses with them. So if you just take care of your lashes, you can use them over and over again. So I was very, very pleased to get these in the box and to try a different brand. And so now I really want to try out the Battington lashes even more. I'm going to check them out. So this was a great thing. I was very, very happy with this. So I guess I have two things kind of that go together. So I have, this is the Pure Sculptor palette. So this came in the May box. It has two contouring shades, a dark and a light, and then two highlighting shades, a light and then also a dark. This retails for $30, and this was in the May box. And then I also have a set of Luxie brushes. So these came in the June box, and these retailed for $42. And you got a set of three. So it's supposed to be one foundation brush, one pointed domed highlighter, and then one stippling brush, dual fiber kind of stippling brush for these guys. So I never use this kind of, this one, it's a little more of a flat brush. This is the 660 precision foundation brush. I never use a brush like this for my foundation. So I actually use this with this pure contour shade. Did you like how I almost dropped it? But I got it. Yay! So I've actually used this with this palette, and I think this brush, because when I do my contour and my bronzer, I like to go in with a bigger kind of fluffy brush to do bronzer kind of all over my face, and then I go in with a smaller brush that's a little bit more, a little flatter on one side. I usually like it. I think it's the R10 from Morphe is that my kind of go-to contour brush, so I was happy with this one. What I was not particularly happy with is this palette. I don't think I really much care for Pure and Pure's like formulas. I felt like especially these contour shades were like super patchy. And like I use them both with the Luxie brushes and also just with my regular everyday brushes that I use for bronzing and contouring. And it still was kind of patchy. I think it blends out, but once you blend it out so that it's not patchy, I don't feel like you get the same kind of color payoff that I would expect or use in my normal contouring routine. So I don't really love this. I don't love it. It gets the job done, but not really. It just takes more work. And I'm like, why, if I'm having a makeup product, especially one that costs $30. Oh, I don't know if I said that. Yes, this was $30. I want it to work better than I think this one did. So yeah, I wasn't super happy with it. The highlights, on the other hand, they were fine. I used them with both my highlighting brush, and then I also went in with the domed Luxie brush. I think they're nice. I don't know if you can tell. They're just super like, do you see that all coming off? They're super like dusty, kind of powdery highlights. Ooh, oh yeah, look, okay. Look at that. Can you see that? I don't know if you can see that. I like the color, and I think, I'm wearing these today. I'm wearing them layered on top of the Tarte highlighter, and I just mix the two colors together. So I think they are pretty. They're nice highlighters. They're just super dusty. They're just a very, very dusty formula, and I don't think there's a really long wear time with these. I feel like all the shimmer really falls, because they're such a dusty formula, once you put them on the face, they look great right away, but then a few hours later, it all kind of just like dissipates because they kind of fluff off the skin and they don't really have a very long lasting time. So overall, I wasn't a big fan of this palette. Like I said, it got the job done. If I was in a pinch and this is all I had, I would use it and could do something with it, but I wouldn't pay $30 for this. And I'm really feeling like maybe I'm just not a big pure fan. Sorry, but that's just how I'm feeling. All right. Okay. Moving right along. The next item, this was also in the April box and one of the items that I took with me on vacation, and I've been really enjoying it. So this is the Brow Gal Instant Tinted Eyebrow Gel. So this was in the April box. It retails for $22. So this came with me on my trip and I think it held up really, really well. I don't particularly like a super defined or like sculpted brow. I kind of like them maybe a little bit more natural. I feel like my face looks weird with a really heavy brow. So I really liked this. I loved that the spoolie and like the little applicator was so tiny. Like, look at that. It's like the tiniest little guy. So I thought this worked well because it was so tiny and also pretty pointy. So you could just kind of, you know, comb it through really easily. And then also with the pointed tip, you could build out, you know, the bottom, like, you know, the tail of the brow, also kind of fill in, you know, a little bit of the heads of the brow. So I thought it worked out really, really well. Yeah, so I thought this was a really good one. The color also was a nice one. So this was in the color brown, 02. So it worked out well for me. It wasn't too dark. It wasn't too light. I was really happy with this product, and I was glad that I was able to take it with me on my trip. Cool. All right, so then the last things, well, actually, we have four more things, but the last three of the last things are all lip products. So first of all, what I have on my lips right now, this is the Ofra Long Lasting Liquid Lipstick. This came in the June box and it retails for $21. So this is, and also in the color Verona, which I like because I'm very much a fan of these kind of like mauvey red brown kind of colors. It's, I think, a really good nude for me. I have never used an Ofra liquid lipstick before, but I am so happy with it. I kind of love it. The formula feels really comfortable, but it also is long wearing. I don't think it like smudges. Yeah, I'm really, really happy with this formula. Like, it doesn't dry down completely, but it lasts a good long time. So I'm really happy. I want to get more Ofra liquid lipsticks. So then the next little guy that I have here, this is the Han Skincare, and this is a lip gloss. So this is kind of a pinky lip gloss, and I really have enjoyed this as well. So this I just kind of tapped it right in the middle of my lip to add a little bit. It's a little bit lighter color, so just tap that in, and I think it works really well. I'm liking it. It's a little bit more of a sticky formula, but it's not overly sticky, and I think it dries down, but also leaves a lot of like the shine. So it's not, the stickiness doesn't really stay. Yeah, it's not bad. I really quite enjoy it. So this came in the May box, and it is $15. This is the Odessi High Definition Liquid Lipstick. Let me swatch this guy. So this is one of the April boxes. This is one of the ones that I unboxed. It's right here. I unboxed in the April box. This one retails for $24. So this is a very nice color. Again, these are all very similar in tone, and I like them all. These are kind of the colors that I tend to gravitate towards with lipsticks anyways. So I was very, very pleased with that. However, with this guy, it does not dry down, kind of like the Ofra one does. The Ofra one dries down, but it's not drying to the lips. This one doesn't dry down. So it's very sticky. It's a super, super, super sticky formula. Yeah, it's really sticky. But I don't know. It leaves a nice shine on your lips because it doesn't dry down completely, but it's a little bit uncomfortable because it is sort of it's a thicker formula and it doesn't dry down. So they say this one is $24. I would probably say it's not worth it for $24 for me. Just because it, like I said, nice color, but it doesn't dry down. So I probably wouldn't pay $24, but since it came in the box, I was happy with it. I think it was a good addition to the box, but not really worth the $24 for me personally. So anyways, last but not least is the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. Ah, this is, oh my gosh, this is such a nice cream. So this came in the June box, and this retails for $10. And this is actually the mini size. So I actually got, for Christmas, I had a set of three of the small size. So this is the small size guy, and then this is the mini. So you can kind of see how they compare in size. Like, the mini is super mini. It is, I don't know how many like ounces this guy is. Here we go. It is 25 milliliters and the large size is 75 milliliters. So this is like a third of the size of this guy. I don't remember how much the small size is because I got it in a set of three at Christmas time. I haven't opened this one yet just because it has like a little seal on it and I have this guy already going and open. Oh my gosh, this is such a nice cream. Like, it just smells, oh, it smells fantastic. I love the way that this smells. It's very, very moisturizing. Like I said, I got it at Christmas time, so I used it throughout the winter. I really, really have enjoyed this. And for $10, or the little one was $10. I think it's worth it. It was a great addition to the box. I'm so happy with it. All right, so that is everything that came in these three boxes for May, June, and July. So kind of just to do a little bit of a rundown. So the April box, it had a total value of $148, which is a pretty high value. So I think that actually was a really good value for me because there were three products that I thought were standouts from that box. It was the ColourPop Golden State of Mind palette, the Dr. Brandt Pores No More vacuum cleaner. So ColourPop was $26, Dr. Brandt was $47, and then the Brow Gel tinted eyebrow gel was $22. So if I add all of those up, the total price of all the items that I really loved in that box was $95. If you add in the Tarte Pro Glow, which again, I was like pleasantly surprised with, but not blown away, that's $29. The total cost of the box, or the total value of the box, was $124. So I thought that was like really, really, really good. Moving on to the May box. So the May box actually had a total value of $179, which is a lot. But actually, I got my money's worth on that one. I got my money's worth on all of them. Oh, why do I always forget this? Disclaimer, I do not get BoxyCharm sent to me. I am on the 3-month plan, so I pay about $19.50 per month. I pay myself. Again, not sponsored, also not an affiliate. Don't get it sent to me. I pay. Disclaimer. So, so the May box had a total value of $179. The things that I thought were standout, really awesome products in the box was the Cover FX Blurring Primer. I loved this guy. This one was $38. And then we had the Pretty Vulgar Ink Eyeliner. That was $24. And then the Han Lip Gloss, which was $15. So if you add all those together, it was $77. If you add in the two brushes, which again were nice. So we had the bigger Aesthetica Face Brush, and which was $27. And then the three-piece Eye Trio, which was $45. So they, like I said, they seemed really nice. And I don't have complaints about the brushes per se. I just think if I was purchasing each of these items individually, the cost for those brushes seemed a little bit high. But when you add those in, that is a total value of $149. So I was actually quite happy with all of those. And then finally, June was a total value of $134. And I actually loved everything from the June box. The only thing that I had like a little bit of a question about would maybe be the three Luxie brushes. Although these just feel a little bit more, like a little bit higher quality than the Aesthetica brushes, and they're bigger brushes. So I don't know, I feel for almost the same price. These were $42 or $43, I think, and the other little mini ones were $45 for three. I don't have a problem paying $15 for, you know, like a powder brush or, you know, a highlighter brush. So these were the only ones, and these are really cute. Like, I like the pink handles, and I love like the little rose gold ferrule. So I was actually quite pleased with these, and I thought they were an okay value. And Luxie's like a, you know, a really nice brush brand. So these felt more worth it to me. So that's why everything in the June box was worth it. So that was a total value of $134. Okay, so that was a lot. The sun has gone down. We've been here together for a long time. Let me adjust the lighting a little bit. How about we open the June box? Okay, I'm gonna do this fast just because, again, I know this is gonna be a long video. I'm nervous. Does anyone else try to like a Christmas present, like shake it and like find out what you have? I don't wanna say, I'm trying to feel. I have a sinking suspicion that I got what I don't want, just because like this is the June box that the Alamar palette came in, and you can see the July box is shorter. So I have a feeling what I got in here, but I don't want to say it because I jinx it. And literally every time I have been very adamant about not wanting something, like I think it was the February box where I was like, I don't want the Z palette. That's such a waste of money. I got it in April when I got the like Tarte highlighter. I was like, I don't want that. And then I got it. So I'm gonna try to not jinx it. I'm not gonna say what it is I don't want, but there's something I don't want. And maybe we'll talk about it in the next month when I review this, because I don't know. I just think the makeup of the boxes for the July box was a little unusual. Just that there was such a big discrepancy between the items. Okay, moment of truth. Let's open it up and see what we got. Okay, so here's the card. They're going to this style. Let's open it. Oh! Well, look at that. I got what I wanted. Okay, so the theme for July is road trippin', which is really cute. Yeah, it's a really cute theme. Oh my gosh, things have never worked out for me that I've gotten like what I wanted. I'm really excited right now. Okay, all right. Calm, mate. Let's calm down and go through this. So let's start with this guy because it's on top. So this is the Wander Beauty Unlashed Volume and Curl Mascara. I like this packaging. This is really different. So this is Oh, I like how the brush is like curved on this guy. Yeah, so this is a volumizing and curling mascara. So this is a retail price of $24. I've actually really wanted to try more Wander Beauty, so I'm excited to give this a go. I always like trying new mascaras. I'm happy for that. And then after that, I got the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. Dr. Brandt No More Baggage Eye Depuffing Gel, which at first I was kind of like, oh, I don't really need that. I don't need that. I'd rather have, you know, a mask or something. And then I didn't get much sleep a few days ago, and I woke up in the morning and I was like, oh, okay. I think you actually do need some like under eye treatment. So this is a good thing. So this actually retails, according to the little card, retails for $42. So again, pretty good. Pretty good price tag. I'm excited to try that out. Next is the Chella Beauty Eyebrow Cream. Oh my gosh, I saw this on their Instagram. This is really cute. So one side is a little brush And then the other side, you like, yeah, you unscrew it and there is like the eyebrow cream in it. So you kind of take the brush and like, you know, and then do your brows. Okay. I have never used a brow pomade before. As you know, I don't really love like a super structured brow, but I've never used an eyebrow pomade before, so I'm excited to give it a try. All right, moving on along. This is the Note Cosmetics Luminous Silk Compact Blusher. This retails for $11.99. Oh, this says it is designed for all skin types. This luminous paraben-free blush adds natural color to your cheeks while preventing dryness. I can't open it. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's cute. Oh, look at that guy. That's really cute. That's a pretty color too. Oh, and it opens up and it comes with a little brush. That's like adorable. I was looking for like a brush or like some kind of blush to like take with me in my purse on my like to-go kit. So this is pretty. It's a little bit more peachy than I normally go to. It's called Desert Rose. It's not really a rose color per se. It's more of like a peachy color, but oh, it's super soft. Oh, that swatches nicely. Can you see that swatch? Yeah, that's pretty. Okay, that, I am so excited about that. I'm excited to give that a try. And that, like I said, yes, it retails for $11.99. And then the last thing that I got in here, which I'm actually so excited about, I can't even tell you. I got the Crown Palette. Yay! Oh, it's like, where are my scissors? So this is the Crown Fuego Eyeshadow Palette. Let's open this guy up. Comes in like this outer unicarton that's just black with the Crown logo in like rose gold on it. And then you take it out and it's again, looks pretty much the same on the inside. So black with the rose gold crown. You open it up. Oh, okay. Okay. This looks really nice. It has a mirror and then it has all the shadows. Ooh, so it's rose gold and it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's 10 shades. It's a 10 palette. Eyeshadow. So let's read about this guy. It says, made of rich, warm tone shades. You know how I feel about warm tone. This creamy, high pigmented palette gives you exactly what you need to create infinite, flawless eye looks. The 4 shimmer shades perfectly complement the 6 matte shades, making this palette for all your glam goals. So this retails for $29.99, so $30, although I did see that it was on sale. I will check and do some research and put that information down here, up here, somewhere. If it's a different price, if you can like get it on sale for less than $30, I'll definitely let you know. So I'm excited to try this guy out. Let me try. I have like glitter on all my fingers. I'm gonna swatch like a couple of these guys. Ooh, those look nice. Those look super nice. I am so excited. Ooh, that one swatched so nice. Wow. Okay. I'm so excited and I'm really, really looking forward to trying this blush out. I think it's gonna be awesome. And these other, especially the Dr. Brandt, I need that. I need to just go to bed earlier, but I'm excited to try it. And the Wander Beauty Mascara. So overall, I am very pleased with my July box. And I will be back next month to review all of these. If you haven't seen my last BoxyCharm unboxing and review from way back in March and April, I have linked that up above. I'll put it here. So, you know you want to keep watching me. I'm kind of funny. I spill things. I make some jokes. So if you want to keep watching, go ahead and click right on this. Also, make sure you subscribe down below. I'm making new content. I have lots of reviews, lots of fun things planned coming up in videos. So check those out. hit that notification bell, click it twice so that you get all notifications and you'll never like miss an upload. Also, feel free to follow me on all of my socials. I'm always over there posting crazy videos of my life and things that I find randomly funny. So thank you so much for hanging out with me. I know this was a long video with lots of products, but I think we got some really good winners in here. Remember, always be beautiful. Love you guys. Bye.